Louisiana Outdoor Adventures is brought to you by Brian Harris Chevrolet, where our trucks haul bass. Some days you just can't choose the weather. Today on Louisiana Outdoor Adventures, Mother Nature is being extremely difficult. 25 mile an hour north winds and a tail end of a front make for extreme conditions. However, two things are working in our favor. We are in Terrebonne Parish, and that means a ton of trout and reds are ganged up in the channels and deep holes. Two, we have an equalizer. Charles Sablatura with Rockport Rattler has a head for catching lock-jawed fish. No secret, we'll tell you all about it. It's the Rockport Rattler series of jig heads, and when the fish hear it, they can't help but track it down. It was the reason for success on a day when all things Kevin Ford were working against us. Wind, rain, muddy water, and no popping cork on the boat. And yet, even our esteemed host could catch a fish using this dinner bell.
And the rattle and the Rockport Rattler and the eyes and the presentation and the sound and the sight, that's why we're catching fish today.
Welcome to Louisiana Outdoor Adventures. Yes! Oh, that's triple! Yep.
He's coming out.
Yeah, big one.
That one's bigger than yours, Ford.
Closed captioning is brought to you by Cypress Cove Marine and Lodge in Venice, Louisiana, where you'll experience world-class fishing. Visit us online at cypresscovevenice.com.
Today's conditions are brought to you by Zatarain's, a New Orleans tradition since 1889.
I've been looking forward to this trip for a long time because Charles Sablatura of Rockport Rattler was going to come in town and fish with us. You know, we've been using these baits for several months now, and just an incredible jig head. It was great to have Charles come in, and we kind of picked a day where the weather was going to be bad, where fishing wasn't going to be real easy. We knew it was going to be a cold, windy day, and we wanted to come down here and really put these jig heads to the test. You've done some testing with this.
Absolutely.
Here, let me help you with your fish. I don't want to change anything here.
Yeah, what we've done is we've actually taken a underwater mic and a testing tank, and we've built our own little jigging machine, so you know, people can't claim that I may be jigging ours harder. You know,
right.
We built a jigging machine that's doing it all for you. And underwater mic hooked to a laptop with some DB meter software on it. We actually test, we'll test a regular jig head with the soft plastic, shove a rattle in the plastic, and test and measure the sound. And then do a test with the same soft plastic, take the rattle out, put it on our heads, and we're about four times louder.
I mean, we had high pressure. We had water that fell 3 feet from yesterday.
He didn't hit it. He just like mouthed it.
Are you complaining,
fish,
brother?
It's a good fish, though.
We went from clear water yesterday to muddy water today, and we had temperatures that never got out of the 40s in the last 48 hours. And we are out here today in Cocodry with Captain Jonathan, and we are fishing on a frigid day. I mean, it's cold, it's in the 40s, it was blowing. But we're gonna show you that with this Rockport Rattler, you can catch fish in any conditions, and we're gonna do it today tough style. We didn't wanna get you out here when it was 60 degrees.
You know, Texas gotta get out of the heat every now and then. So.
That normally makes for a fishing trip where you're gonna get skunked. But in Terrebonne Parish with the Rockport Rattlers, we caught fish.
In the new year, the choice is clear. Get more and pay less at Brian Harris Chevrolet. You get more Chevys, 300 on site now. You pay less money. The 2012 Silverado regular cab is now just $17,995. 2012 Silverado extended cabs go for $22,995. The choice is clear in the new year. You get more and you pay less at Brian Harris Chevrolet on Florida.
Hey, before we hit our first fishing hole, our first stop is at a local Cracker Barrel convenience store. They have everything we need. Fuel, ice, drinks, snacks, and more, and even plenty of room at the pumps for your boat. With over 50 locations throughout Louisiana, there is sure to be a locally owned Cracker Barrel location near you. Cracker Barrel convenience stores, we have more than you expect.
Your fishing adventure of a lifetime is just an hour southwest of New Orleans in Houma, Louisiana. From Cocodrie, Four Points du Large, Point Ashen, we've got it all. Inshore and offshore saltwater fishing at its best. You'll find over 30 charter fishing services, marinas, great restaurants, and abundant accommodations. Experience world-class fishing in the heart of Louisiana's wetlands. Plan your adventure today by visiting www.fishhoma.com. You deserve it.
Lafitte Harbor Marina, located on the C&M Bayou Fuel Dock, is your ticket to some of the best fishing along the Louisiana Gulf Coast. Located just 25 miles from New Orleans, Louisiana, we are a full-service marina offering guided saltwater fishing charters, commercial boat rentals, waterfront lodging, RV parking, fuel, and a well-stocked marine supply and tackle store. Lafitte Harbor Marina is your one stop on your way to good times down on the bayou. Come fish with the best at Team Lafitte Harbor.
Zatarain's, so much New Orleans flavor, you'll wonder how we do it. From jambalaya to yellow rice, jazz it up with Zatarain's.
Nauticstar's Making Waves is one of the fastest growing names in the boating industry. Quality boats that last and perform. Nauticstar boats are built for fishermen by fishermen. Bay boats from 18 to 24 feet and offshore boats from 20 to 25 feet, Nauticstar builds a boat for you. Compare construction, compare performance, and compare features, and you'll see why Nauticstar blows the competition away. Visit us online at nauticstarboats.com to find a dealer near you. This segment of Louisiana Outdoor Adventures is brought to you by Wilco Marsh Buggies. Where there are no roads, all roads lead to Wilco. Today's gear is brought to you by Aquamarine and Denham Springs, your Nauticstar Stratos and Sea Arc dealer.
Another nice fish, Rockport Rattler, black and chartreuse. The reason why we're using black and chartreuse is because the water got a little bit dirtier today. And, you know, you'll see all the different color heads. We've been featuring this black head with the yellow eye, but we've got them in just the natural color. We've got them in white. We've got them in yellow, pink, red, whatever color you want, from an eighth of an ounce for salt water all the way up to a half ounce. You know, the Rockport Rattler, it's real simple. Noise attracts fish.
Oh, another one.
You got a trout? Let's bring him over here, Captain Jonathan. I'm doing pretty good with the taking the fish off the hook deal. I'm pretty good at that. Tell you what, we're in just a dead-end canal. We've got about 6 or 7 feet of water here in the middle. The tide is just starting to move. We've got a little sunshine right now, and that's going to help us tremendously. When you have these cold days and that sun comes up a little bit, you don't know the difference it makes. And the rattle that's built into this jig head helps to attract the fish. Captain Jonathan, he's fishing with the black jig head too. I'm the only one fishing with the white jig head right now. There's been two fish caught on a black jig head. It makes you think. Maybe something to it, maybe not be something to it. But we're fishing with an opening night, and he's fishing, dipping it with a little dipping glow. Marilure, quarter ounce jig head, and that's what we're doing. And that is a nice trout.
That is a nice trout. What we find with our baits is that they will improve your odds no matter what the conditions are.
It's my color.
A little black and chartreuse action.
Yes, sir. That's my color.
Nice trout, buddy.
Ooh, so we could come out on a banner day and have fish just jumping out of the boat, and you know it's just going to be a great day of fishing. And really, did the jigs make a difference? We feel yes, they would make a difference, but it's hard to prove. But you can come out on a day like today, high pressure, cloudy, windy, cold, and the fish just very lethargic, and we can get them and entice them, and we have an ice chest full of nice fish today. Of course, Louisiana is the fish mecca, but there's no other better place to come out and demonstrate our baits.
Little guy.
Oh, so now you're, now, Now you're complaining about the size of your fish?
Oh, he's growing.
Now let me ask you a question. On a day like this,
it's a bass.
It's a bass.
Largemouth bass.
Yes, sir.
All right, we got a drum.
So far we've seen trout, drum, reds, and grandma largemouth.
No, that's a, you know what that is right there? You're in Louisiana. That's a green trout.
It's a green trout?
Yeah, it's a green trout.
All right.
You gotta know the lingo.
Little Rockwell Rider.
Well, since I'm not catching any fish and you are, and you got a plane to catch, you better get back out there again. You know, we talk about the rattler and all that, but the way that they've done the eyes and the black jig head we were using today with the yellow eyes, I mean, you could see it in the water. You could see how that eye flashes, and that gets a reaction strike.
Another.
Jonathan, why don't you and I just sit down and talk and do something?
Another trout.
You having fun?
I am.
Good.
Thanks for inviting me.
I'm glad I did invite you. You know, from being out of town, how blessed are we here?
Oh, this is an amazing fishery. You know, if we were in our area, in Rockport area, we'd be, you know, there'd be loaded up with boats around here because we just don't have the water. We don't have the amount of fishery you have here. On a day like this where it started out at 40 degrees and we got up this morning, or on a day on a weekend when it's busy, it's not busy like what we see it in Texas because you've got so much water you can spread out in here.
You know, a lot of these soft plastic bait companies, they'll put a rattle in the soft plastic. Well, you catch a fish, number one, it's not gonna be as good of a rattle. Number two, you're gonna lose the rattle, that's 40 or 50 cents. We've got them built right into the jig head. And I'm positioned right in the middle of the boat here to where I can take him off the hook.
That's a good looking trout.
No need you taking him off. A nice trout. What Jonathan's saying right now is we've got a shallow flat here on the left-hand side. And if you draw an imaginary line from here to that point where we are, anything to the left of it is real shallow. And then it's going to drop off into about 6 feet of water. And we've got the tide coming in. So we're just casting off the ledge, letting the baits come off the ledge. And hopefully these fish are going to be feeding in about 5 or 6 feet of water. And that's where Jonathan caught that nice little speckled trout. From crappie all the way up to a half ounce now, you can buy these Rockport Rattlers. Call this a Rockport Red. You can only keep a bad man down for so long before he gets lucky, Charles. That's a good red right there. Woo! He is taking some drag.
Taking some drag. Take the sightseeing tour around the boat.
Well, I tell you what, these things are so much fun to catch. No, big drum. Drum redfish. I thought this was a red, but
how about a net?
Good old black drum. And he is going to town. Tell you one thing, a lot of times when you find these bad boys, you're going to find more than one. And that's a good one right there.
Yeah, that's a nice one.
I tell you what, these things are just as good to eat as a redfish. You know, you give me a drum that size, man, they're delicious.
They're excellent. You get the big ones, you don't want them. But
no,
this size are excellent fare.
Yep. Let's get him.
Barbecue on the half shell.
And Charles, what is that right there? That's a
black gold eye.
What?
And did you go black gold? Chartreuse?
Yeah. If you can't beat them, join them, brother.
That's right.
What I've always said. But a kokodree drum.
Why go fishing when you can go catching instead? Plaquemines Parish is your gateway to big fish and big fun, courtesy of America's best fishing guides and waters that are teeming with tuna, tarpon, marlin, snapper, speckled trout, bass, redfish, and more. Pros in the know call Plaquemines America's year-round fishing hotspot with marinas in Burris, Myrtle Grove, Point Lahash, Empire, and Venice. Visit catchfishla.com to book your trip. Plaquemines Parish, it's catching.
Regardless of the fishery, the pursuit is still the same. The strike, the hookup, and the realization that you do still have a pulse. Find it with Akuma. Leading an industry in innovative design and advanced technology, Akuma Fishing Tackle is home to the most exciting equipment available. The revolutionary Makaira, Cedros Reels and Rods, all new Citrix Bass Rods and Reels, Andro's two-speed reels and jig rods, Trio crossover spinning reels, billfish to bass, tuna to trout. There is no stopping Akuma.
MiraLure, the right tools to catch them.
There he is. Oh, baby. Oh, yeah.
Turn on the bite anytime. Tie on a MiraLure.
The best fishermen know that Venice, Louisiana is the place where you catch fish, and Lighthouse Lodge and Villas is located just minutes from Venice's marinas. Stay at Lighthouse Lodge and enjoy our brand new Bahamas-style rooms with all the comforts like satellite TV, Wi-Fi, refrigerators, and microwaves. Or stay in our condo-style villas and choose to have your own kitchen and room for the family. Either way, our staff is here to make your stay in Venice a great one. Escape to Sportsman's Paradise at Lighthouse Lodge and Villas. Toughline is the leader in high-performance premium braided fishing line. Compact, small in diameter, longer cast, higher abrasion resistance, and zero shedding separates Toughline from the rest. Ask for Toughline today at your local tackle dealer.
Think all jig heads are the same? They're not. With its unique rattle chamber, the Rockport Rattler is literally a dinner bell for fish. So unique, it was awarded a U.S. patent. The light reflecting eyes work well in both clear and muddy water, and colors and sizes separates the Rockport Rattler from the rest. The Rockport Rattler works for both salt and freshwater species. Just add your favorite soft plastic, cast, and tell the fish it's supper time. The Rockport Rattler, a jig head that fish can hear, available at tackle stores near you or online at www.rockportrattler.com.
People have been winning tournaments for a long time by inserting rattles inside soft plastic baits and using that noise attractant to win bass tournaments, even to win saltwater tournaments. But you catch a fish and usually that rattle will squirt out of the bait. And you just lost the 40-cent rattle. And we had to actually have a custom rattle built specifically for us, and they're not cheap, but we get those made specifically for the Rockport Rattler, so that allows us to make that rattle right alongside the hook and marry it with that hook. The rattle's held in place by the lead surrounding that flange, and then that rattle coming alongside that hook allows that the actual lead metal, as well as the steel of the hook, are very good sound resonators, and it allows those properties of that sound resonating to actually magnify the sound of the rattle outside the soft plastic bait.
We shouldn't be catching anything today, because this is the absolute, perfect storm for bad fishing. On a day like today, baits make a difference, and the rattle and the Rockport Rattler and the eyes and the presentation and the sound and the sight, that's why we're catching fish today, because other than that, there's no reason to be catching fish in these conditions. Redfish!
All right.
Nice red, Captain Jonathan. Sometimes you gotta get in the right spot, and when you find reds a lot this time of the year, they're going to be kind of stacked up, and we're hoping that we have found a pile. We're going to find out here pretty soon, but another nice Kokodri Terrebonne Parrish redfish on a Rockport Rattler and a MiraLure soft plastic. If a fish has a blue tail, that means they're feeding. Well, if you catch a fish, aren't they feeding? So, but one of the things you can read on a fish, especially this time of year, is to look at the bottom of them. If you look at the bottom of these fish, they have these little leeches on them. And that means these fish are probably holding in deeper water and sitting on the bottom. And that's what Jonathan just noticed, that he's catching these fish off the drop-off in the deeper water. And you can tell by looking at the bottom of the fish that this one's been sitting on the bottom. So wintertime fishing, look at your fish. They can answer a lot of questions for you. Fishing today, one word, tide.
Got him.
Nice. Nice red. And again, like you said, Jonathan, right off the drop-off. Another beautiful redfish. I'll tell you what, when I have my tough line like that, I can just flip them in the boat, because it's the best braid on the market. Now what I did, I went to a 3-inch bait. They're fishing with 4-inch baits, I'm fishing with a 3-inch soft sardine from MiraLure right now. A lot of times in the winter time, you downsize your baits, and that's what I did, and I'm upsizing my catch. Hide from what? Not the fish, but the wind. I mean, the wind has been blowing 20 to 25 knots all day, so the key for us today was to stay in the protected areas. Let me do it. May want to fish in this hole for a minute. we were about to make a little move.
That's a nice fish.
I hooked onto a red, and then Charles has hooked onto the biggest red of the day. So I'm thinking that we may want to make a couple of casts here. Just my personal.
He hit it the cast before.
Observation.
Or at least someone related to him.
That's a good redfish, buddy.
That's a nice. That's the tug I like.
You like that?
Oh, I love it.
Stay in the canals that had trees on the bank where the wind wasn't so bad, and where the wind wasn't bad close in, closer to the marina and to the dock, that's where we were able to find the clean water, and that's where the fish were. All right, Charles, you got him beat.
Well,
I'll tell you one thing. I found the key to success today. Because let's say we're going to move spots.
One last cast. Grab a seat. No, I'm going to grab a red.
I know. You were still fishing. You know, the captain said, you know, we're going to make a move here, guys. Yeah. And you said, not so fast.
Yeah.
I'll tell you one thing.
I prefer to get this big boy in.
One thing, and we talked about this a little bit earlier, but when you're fighting redfish, a lot of times when you're fishing with some garbage jig head, by the time you get it out of the fish's mouth, it's bent in 100 different directions. Let me tell you something. This is a mustad hook on here, and it is strong, and it ain't going nowhere. Now, the problem is when you put your finger there, that's sharp in a redfish. So right now, I'm in a little bit of pain, but I'm trying to man up, and I'm going to go to the back of the boat before I start screaming for my mom.
In the new year, the choice is clear. Get more and pay less at Brian Harris Chevrolet. You get more Chevys, 300 on site now. You pay less money. The 2012 Silverado regular cab is now just $17,995. 2012 Silverado extended cabs go for $22,995. The choice is clear in the new year. You get more and you pay less at Brian Harris Chevrolet on Florida.
C&M Bayou Fuel Dock and Boat Rentals in Lafitte has work boats from 19 to 36 feet, and we deliver anywhere and anytime. C&M also has TransCube fuel transportation tank rentals up to 1,240 gallons. Our ship store is fully stocked with the supplies you need to get the job done. Batteries, oil, marine paint, rope, pumps, and more. It's all at C&M Bayou Fuel in Lafitte. Visit us online at bayoufuel.com and cnmboatrentals.com today, or call us at 504-689-2013.
Since April of 2010, more than 2,300 seafood samples from waters off Louisiana's coast have been tested by dedicated citizens for safety. Now you can access all of those results on a public website called GulfSource.org. Search by sample type, location, and more. Get the facts about fresh, delicious Louisiana seafood. You be the judge, we'll be the source. Visit us at GulfSource.org.
Out of the swamps of South Louisiana comes one of the finest fishing destinations in the world, Cypress Cove Marina and Lodge in Venice. Our lodge offers 61 newly remodeled rooms with free Wi-Fi and a ship store with all of the supplies you need for a day on the water. Cypress Cove Marina also features a dry stack storage facility, 8 fuel pumps, a 3-lane back down launch, and fish cleaning station. From bass to blue marlin, come to Cypress Cove in Venice, where your dreams become a reality.
Fishing. It's where good stories come from. It's about good times and family and friends. It's about taking a couple home for dinner tonight and saving a few for tomorrow. It's all about that and so much more. To CCA, fishing is about enjoying today and making sure tomorrow is even better. To us, fishing comes with a responsibility for the resources we enjoy so much. If fishing means all that to you, then you belong with CCA.
Zatarain's. So much New Orleans flavor, you wonder how we do it. From jambalaya to yellow rice, jazz it up with Zatarain's.
How the Pros Do It is brought to you by Demco Electric. We connect lives.
You know, on a day like today, baits make a difference. And the rattle and the Rockport Rattler, and the eyes, and the presentation, and the sound, and the sight,
That's why we're catching fish today, because other than that, there's no reason to be catching fish in these conditions. And if this bait works like that in these conditions, just wait till you get it right. And you've seen it before on TV. It's for real.
Work.
Already, huh?
Excellent. That didn't take long. Small red, I think. I don't think that's a trout. I thought this was like a little 12-inch redfish. Look at that fish, man.
That's a good one.
Didn't take long at all for this one to hear the dinner bell. And the dinner bell is the Rockport Rattler. Bass.
Right there, huh?
That's a big bass.
It's a bass?
Yeah.
All right.
Look at that. It's not a bad bass at all. It was kind of funny. We pulled up to this spot and Jonathan looked over and there was something crashing a minnow on the bank. He's like, oh, that was a red. So we just put a throw right there and no, it wasn't a red, but it was a nice healthy bass. It's a great thing, you know, you get down here and you got brackish water to where you can catch redfish, speckled trout, bass, all in the same hole.
Some of those black ones.
Yeah. You're exact. That's a trout. Woo!
Trout?
Yeah, and he's happy. I mean, he is. I think he's unhappy.
Need a net?
No, I don't need a net. Nice trout, though. Leave it to Kay.
That's to catch a the good
biggest,
trout.
Yeah, I catch the biggest fish of the day. Biggest trout of the day.
Sweet.
How about that? And notice, they all hit the these baits in. All the way in. You will catch a lot of these fish because they head strike these fish because of the rattle. That's what attracts them. And the eyes. And the pliers that I wish I had. Oh, there we go. But look.
I would say our jig head would rival live bait fishing. I would say it actually, in a lot of instances, will actually outperform live bait fishing.
Looks like he may have a speckled trout. Which
nice
he does.
Trout,
nice trout. Nice trout. And the problem with Charles having the speckled trout here is that he has got a flight that leaves in about 3 hours. But the great thing about fishing in Terrebonne Parish is we're only an hour away from New Orleans International Airport. Okay. Hey, check out the website, rockportrattler.com, for all the information on these baits. They're going to be available all over Louisiana very, very soon. And they are available nationwide. Check out our website at loatv.net and also go to Facebook, search Louisiana Outdoor Adventures and like us. You want to do that because we're going to have all kinds of contests and the only way you can win is to like us on Facebook, so do that as well. We hope you enjoyed today's show. For producer John Jackson and videographer Joey Bordelon, I'm Kevin Ford saying thanks for watching Louisiana Outdoor Adventures and we hope to see you next time where we're going to do it Louisiana style.